of Florida State University is proud to present the 41st edition of the internationally acclaimed Flying High Circus, the greatest collegiate show on earth. All of these adventurous performers, including myself, are students at the Florida State University. Since the circus is primarily an extracurricular activity, these students participate on their leisure time after school. The performers receive no tuition waivers or any kinds of scholarships for their participation. But due to their hard work and determination...
Ooh, almost.
We will teach the flyer how to miss a trick and land himself safely in the net before we let him go across to the catcher.
Everybody gone? Have you all gone?
One more.
Oh, you don't have the... Okay.
We have like 25 acts that we can teach at the circus. The shows that we have are usually 10-act shows. That's why we try to keep the numbers up so much and the numbers of students involved.
Well, that's what circus is. Circus is just a really big show, and we do it all. We do the sets, we do the staging, we do, you know, we make the costumes. The women get to make all the costumes. We spend the last month before home show madly sewing. We finish about 2 hours after we're supposed to have our final dress rehearsal. What happens is we do road shows every few weekends, year-round, and your road shows are a lot smaller than what people in Tallahassee see here as home show. It's scaled down, but it is a lot of fun.
There's never any time when we're away from each other more than a month. We have like regular breaks, like Christmas vacation, we have all that off, and weekends, and but even our spring break, we go on a road show.
We try to average 10 to 12 road shows during the year. We try to average that many so that we can keep up our revenue. That's how the circus survives, through doing our performances.
Kevin just wants him to get stuck. I know. He'll make you go back and forth. Kevin has no deal.
Here we go. We can see him get stuck.
10 more feet, okay? Ah, good.
Most of the pre-show stuff is done by the students. They learn good, hard physical labor, for one thing. They learn to work with other people, like them or not, you know, real life situations. They learn to depend on other people and interact with these other people. They learn public relations for themselves in the circus. They're always promoting Florida State University. For example, when we're on a road show, we are representing Florida State University and promoting Florida State University. So I think it's a real learning experience for all of our students.
Callaway Gardens in Georgia, that's like one big long 3-month road show. We perform, you know, mostly every day there. You learn so much there, you just intense practice, and you're dealing with people one-on-one, and you get to know your audience, and that's a whole other element. And they see you during the day when you're working, and they come and watch you at night when you perform.
Summer program is a 12-week-long program that begins around Memorial Day each summer and continues into August. The circus serves as the focal point for the entire summer's activities. The kids continue to be top quality. And I guess after the flowers, people think synonymously of Callaway Gardens and FSU Circus.
At Callaway, by that 12th week of the summer, you're doing eight shows a week. It's more like a job then, by that 12th week at Callaway.
Considering where Linda Barron, Don Durfus, Kevin McDonald, Paul O'Grady, Terry Zinhauser, Joe Town, and Michael Shiver perform on the teeter boards.
If I can get up and wear tights in front of, you know, all these people and flip around in the net, and I figure I can get up in front of anybody and do just about anything.
Linda Barron, Don Durfus, Paul O'Grady, Kevin McDonald, Terry Zinhauser, Joe Town, and Michael Shiver on the teeter boards.
All right, good one. When you're up high or down low anywhere in the circus and you're taking a risk, you know that risk is going to be there. And you know that there's 1,001 things that can happen in any second. Anything can happen.
But you still have to trust the person that you're with, because if you don't, that just makes the risk even bigger.
The risk is well worth it to me. We were doing high casting, and the hardest maneuver in high casting is probably the mount. And we were going up for a mount, and I was bringing her up, and Missy came over the top, and she just hit it in the right place. You know, it was a fluke accident. Nobody could have helped it. Nothing could have been done. It's going to limit me a little bit in my lateral stability in my right knee, and I'll probably always have to wear a brace during sports. There's varying degrees of danger, and I think danger is one of the things that makes sports exciting. Immediately after the accident, the first thing I wanted to do was get back in and start. I hated sitting around. I love the circus dearly. There's no other way to explain it. You have to be there to understand it.
There's not really much fear of injury or hurt if you trust the people you're working with. And you know you're not going to get hurt because you can trust yourself.
Skills of agility on the hanging perch pole.
I was in a circus in my hometown for 6 years, and a lot of people that had been in that came to Florida State and did it, and I heard about it through that. That was my reason for coming to Florida State mostly. The helicopter spin on hanging perch is my favorite because it's something that it's challenging, but it's fun, and I think it looks neat.
Dale Austin and Stephanie Campbell on the Hanging Perch Pole.
Sports Spectacular presents from the campus of Florida State University, The Circus Goes to College. This circus tent is unlike any other circus tent in the world. At first glance, it looks like a real circus tent. And it is. It has three rings, a tambark floor, and all the riggings necessary for putting on the greatest show on earth. It's big, colorful, and exciting. Its uniqueness lies in the fact that it was put up and is maintained entirely by college students. And it sits smack dab in the middle of the campus of Florida State University in Tallahassee.
First of all, I'd like to introduce the founder of the Florida State University Circus, the gentleman this complex is named after, Mr. Jack Haskin. Coach?
Jack Haskin was brought down here to develop an activity for the co-ed institution that was formalized in 47.
We need something that we can use as an activity, both girls and boys in it, that will kind of gel and start the thing off right here, because we're going to hit that place just at the time that the boys are coming in on campus for the first time.
Start coming, and then you do your first show, and you get a little crowd reaction, and that's really all you'll ever need. Because when the crowd claps, it's quite a high.
The enthusiasm of the low casting act. Introducing Paul O'Grady, Tim Nettles, and Don Durfus on the low casting ring.
Yeah, I've always been this way. I guess that's one of the reasons I got in it, because I just love the adventure of life. I'd just try anything. This is like a good opportunity to really channel it. I've never been injured to any good extent. I've had bruises and rope burns and cuts, and most of them are on the rigs. Most of them are when you're working, not performing. No, just like a good 4-year experience here at school. When you look back, you know, I have my scrapbook and I have my memories and I always had my friends.
Off and shoot through. I wish Chris would tell me I didn't have to do the foot to knee. I have to hang there by one hand.
Yeah. You know that act doesn't have an end.
I'm sorry?
You know that act doesn't have an end.
Yeah, I know.
From the minute we come back from Callaway in the fall, we come back around the end of summer, you know, we get right into practice, the fall practice schedule and the spring practice schedule.
As long as they don't have to
and everything centered around home show. From that point, we get new people that come out in the fall in the class, start getting acts together, new acts and old, start practicing all over again and preparing it and getting costumes ready and thinking about music. And the tent will go up at after the new year, and that'll be still toward home show. It's just one weekend of home show, but everything's aimed right toward it. It's our biggest show we have.
You spend just about all year preparing for it, as far as the making of the costumes, the practicing to get the acts just fine-tuned, I mean, just as best as they can be. You go to road shows and you perform for these people, and you still show them your best side, but it's not as personal. Home show's really, you know, the big show for us.
One home show, I did eight acts. That's a 20-act show, and that was a lot. On average, you'll do anywhere from 2 to 3 acts if you've been in for a while.
I believe Skypole was probably the best act that I was able to do, and I always came off feeling really just terrific, proud of myself and proud of my partners.
In center ring is Michael Shiver, Don Durfus, and Quincy Luce performing with what a number of professional circuses would refer to as the Russian pole. We call it the Sky Pole. Watch as Don Durfus, Michael Shiver, and Quincy Luce combine their talents to execute one of the most difficult tricks ever to be performed on a flexible pole. Watch closely as Quincy Luce will attempt a double back somersault. Michael Shiver and Quincy Luce on the Sky Pole.
Flying can be very difficult just from show to show. You've got to adapt to a different rig each time.
This usually happens. You'll think about this overnight, and then the next time you come out, you'll do it, and it comes out right.
I think about it a lot.
Okay. All right, you can roll on out. Take the hooks, clips to them.
Sometimes for home show, you know people in the audience, so you put just that little extra into it just to show off a little or whatever.
The most challenging has been to become a catcher. That took the longest for me to get the skills just to make the catch lock. And that's something you never, ever finish learning.
I'm calling time a little early. I'm calling the time where I call for fall shoot over, and that seemed to have ironed his out real good. The practices become stale. They get frustrated, you know, because they feel like they're just beating their head up against the wall, and they just can't do it. And then all of a sudden, things click, and it's caught, and you're back on the board, and it's... You get such a good feeling that you've accomplished something like that. It's what you're out there for, that feeling of accomplishment.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Flying Circus.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Flying Seminole!
Thanks. We do hope that you have enjoyed our show. My name is Rufus Chester from West Palm Beach, Florida. And I wish that all your days could be circus days. We thank you and wish you all a good night. Thank you.
Just the Mexican was made out of that.